Hey guys, it's me, Veralyn. So I'm almost 25 now, and gone are the days where getting married or having a baby will get the response, "You're too young." And apparently, that memo has gone out to more than a few people in my circle. I mean, this year alone, I've been to 3 weddings and 4 baby showers. And I love helping my friends celebrate, you know, don't get me wrong. But I hate those "who's gonna be next" conversations, you know, the ones that put on all the pressure. Am I the only one that feels this?
Are you feeling any pressure to start a family?
Not from anyone else, but I guess I'm pressuring myself.
How so?
Because, you know, you get to, I guess, 18, you feel like you're going to be 21 the next year. You get to 21, you feel like you're going to be 25. 25, I feel like I'm going to be 30 and not even have, you know, someone to even think about.
For me, majority of my friends, they started, like the weddings started coming like a few years ago, and now the children are slowly coming at this moment, like this year. So yeah, it's getting up there, you know, and just to see that I've gone to so many weddings, and now to see all my friends starting families, and that I'm still sort of looking. So that's, you know, it, that kind of, you know, it does get to me a little bit, but you know, I try not to let it affect me.
When you did get married at 22, right? Do you think that put pressure on any of your girlfriends to be like, "Oh, wow, you know, I guess I better start looking for the one as well"?
Right. Well, you know, I did hear some comments from girls' parents and, you know, other friends, and saying, "Hey, like, you know, when is this going to happen?" You know, for other people, which, I mean, you know, everyone's relationship is different and everyone's timing is different.
With my mom, she's now like bringing in like marriage, and I'm like, where is this coming from? Like,
well, that's one of the things I kind of want to explore, just that whole, especially for girls, that you're not supposed to date, leave boys alone the whole time you're growing up,
right?
And then all of a sudden it's supposed to be, all right, so where's the husband?
Right, exactly. Like, where does he come from? Like, you just, I don't know, pops out of nowhere, and like, what is this whole, I don't know, like, I mean, back home, and so when I say, well, it's weird to say back home, but if I say back home, I'm referring to Senegal, I guess. It's not necessary, like, in these times, people are very modernized. People date. I mean, my cousins are dating more than I'm dating, for sure. They can tell me more about relationships than I would ever know. But to my parents, I think they still refer back to those times when they grew up, because that's the memories that they hold. And for them, it was okay not to date. It was like, I mean, it's a Muslim, it's a predominantly Muslim culture. So there are arranged marriages.
There aren't necessarily pressures, as there is a status quo that, you know, Dominicans get married young, they have kids young. You know, me being 24, my older brother didn't have a child of his own until he was 26. And he's been with his wife now for well over 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And people tend to have that surprising look when they say, "Oh, you're 24, you don't have any kids, or you're not married." So it's more of a status quo. But it's the same thing of, everybody else is jumping off a bridge. Are you going to jump with them? You know, it's just not right. You need to do things when you're ready.
Getting married is a sign of responsibility. It's a sign of family value, you know. Being, if you're not married, you're just like, why are you not being responsible enough to start a family of your own?
I've been thinking about this lately. Like, I'm not sure if it's what I actually want or if I've internalized these like values and norms from the community that I come from, that this is like the ideal to get married by a certain age and to have a certain number of kids. And so I'm sort of like, right now I'd say, yeah, that's what I want, but that's because that's the model I see.
I don't have kids right now. And sometimes I don't know, like, if I were to have a child right now, if I'd be able to balance everything.
Mm.
Because, you know, I get home, I'm so tired. I don't see myself like, okay, I'm home now and I'm going to be super mom and I'm going to take care of this and take care of that. Like, I don't see it, you know. So I feel that is hard.
Mm.
It is hard.
Maybe some person will be worth it and change it for me. And that will be it. That moment will be the defining moment. But I don't know.
Yeah, that was going to be one of my next questions, which is like, well, maybe it's just that we haven't found the person that we would get married to.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. And I'm not denying that. I'm not saying that's impossible. I'm just saying I don't need to do it because everyone is telling me this is when it should happen, because I'm now 24 and, you know, like,
tick, tick, tick.
Yeah, time, the clock is ticking. Like, really, the clock is ticking for my other goals too.
That's totally where I am right now, focused on my career and trying to see the world. But your focus may be to start your life with the person that you love, and that's okay too. I'm just over all the pressure.